Welcome to Kyle Field, home of the 12th man, one of the best home field advantages in all of college football, and home of high expectations in year three of the Jimbo Fisher era. It's the Aggies playing host to the Vanderbilt Commodores. Mike Morgan with Heisman Trophy winner Andre Ware. Taylor Davis is patrolling the sidelines tonight. And we are excited, as many of you are watching at home. Many said we wouldn't have college football in 2020. Greg Sankey and the SEC had other ideas, and Andre Ware, here we are, could not be more excited.
Yeah, really couldn't wait, Mike, for the SEC to get itself going and get started. You're finally going to get to see a good brand of football each and every week. You know that's what the SEC is going to provide. Look at this, the AP top 25, eight teams, over half the conference in the top 25 to start the season. Couldn't wait for this one to get going.
As usual, there are several talented quarterbacks in the SEC, but only one three-year starter in Kellen Mond.
Yeah, a guy, very talented young man who decided to come back to Texas A&M and just continue to work on his game. We know that he can make plays like this when things are off schedule. He's accurate with the football. Wanted to come back, work on his pocket presence. He's been able to improve in that area. And we know just things off schedule, he's deadly accurate with the football. I think he's one of the best quarterbacks in the entire country and is set for a big, big year.
52 career touchdown passes for the senior Kellen Mond. High expectations for him. Higher expectations for Vanderbilt, coming off a 3-9 campaign, somewhat disappointing. And Derek Mason and company have made wholesale changes, including two new coordinators, excited about what the future has for the Commodores.
Yeah, Mike, he decided to shake things up on both sides of the ball, bringing in new coordinators. Todd Fitch comes over. They won 10 games at Louisiana Tech. He was there as well, went to four straight bowl games. That's the offense. You'll see multiple sets. They'll just get the ball out quickly, change tempos. On the defensive side, it's Ted Roof, who basically employs that same 3-4 style of defense. It's been a match in terms of coaching heaven, so to speak, with he and Mason. Mason saying that he's learned things from Ted Roof, who's won a national championship at Auburn, been to a lot of other big-time programs, and now dropping his anchor in Vanderbilt.
Teams have only met two times in the past. The Aggies have won both meetings. As we check in now, the third member of our sideline or our broadcast team, Taylor Davis. Taylor, excited about the environment. Going to be a little bit different tonight, but still a great one here in College Station.
You're absolutely right, Mike. It's taken a lot to get us here, but SEC football is back. But it does look different. You're absolutely right. Kyle Field has been reduced to just 25% capacity. That has about 27,000 fans in attendance here tonight. But the traditions will continue. The entire Aggie band has been permitted to be in attendance tonight, as have the Yell leaders. The Midnight Yell was held virtually last night, but the leaders can be found up in the stands tonight on platforms. As for the players, everyone has been tested three times for COVID-19 this week. But guys, as different as everything is this year, the energy on the sidelines tonight is palpable. Think about it. These guys did not know if there would be a season this year. There's just a lot of enthusiasm to get between the lines tonight.
I can take and hear the crowd already in College Station. And when you think about it, Andre, this might be the largest crowd for a sporting event post-COVID. This is actually a pretty good home field advantage considering what we've been through lately. Toe meets leather. We're underway, and Vanderbilt will have the football first at the 25-yard line, and we'll get our first look at the true freshman quarterback, Ken Seals.
Yeah, very mature for his age. Had an outstanding high school career where he threw for over 5,700 yards, 53 TDs in his in that career in high school. Coach Mason said, hey, he's just poised. He doesn't play like a freshman, distributes the ball, and knows the entire offense in a very, very short period of time.
They're young at quarterback. They're young at virtually every skilled position. They lost a lot of production from a year ago. Seals will start things off in the shotgun on first down. They'll go to the ground game. Not much doing there. Wrapped up near the line of scrimmage was Marlowe. And on the stop was Michael Clemens.
Yeah, reshuffle the offensive line. So they're looking to try to really establish the line of scrimmage, see if they can move this big Texas A&M defensive front led by Bobby Brown. Try to move them around a little bit and get some room for this back, the backs to maneuver.
Aggies show blitz, quick throw, deflected at the line of scrimmage. Dr. Pepper Fansville giving fans the keys to the ball game, Andre.
And for Vanderbilt offensively, they can't give up penetration on the, along the offensive front. They've got to contain this defensive line, then contain the run when they're on the defensive side. For A&M, they got to hit shot plays with Kellen Mond, worked on that all offseason long, and really defensively control the line of scrimmage, which we're seeing them do very early in this ball game.
Yeah, it was Jaden Peavy deflecting that pass at the line. The line to strengthen this Aggies defense on third and long. Draw play, big hole left side. And it's Marlowe racing out of bounds near midfield at the 48-yard line.
Javion Marlowe, the junior running back, kind of a misdirection play. Gets a great block by their center, Grant Miller, right in the middle. Hits it right in stride, a nice big hole. And when a back can hit it full speed, well, that is danger to a defense.
Marlowe, a highly touted back out of Winter Haven, Florida. Our first big play for the Vanderbilt offense.
He was one of two freshmen, true freshmen, to play in 2018. Got some action early in his career.
On first down, they'll keep it on the ground, left side, and nothing doing that time. Marlowe is drilled. A couple of Aggies there leading the way, including Leon O'Neill, one of the talented safeties on this Aggies defense.
Yeah, he's a USA All-American, coming out, U.S. Army All-American, coming out of high school, and they really, really think that he's had a great fall camp and is set for an outstanding 2020 season.
They lost their top running back, their top receiver, their top tight end. And a true freshman at quarterback in Seals out of the gun on second down. Another draw play between the tackles, and this time it's Wakefield tripped up. And brought down by Buddy Johnson, who had 77 tackles a year ago.
Play that was basically opposite of the big run that Marlowe hit, coming from the other direction, where they zone block and allow for a cutback. Nice job there, just getting it to a manageable situation here on third down and four.
Wakefield in the backfield to the right of Seals. Rolls out right. Cox and fires complete at the 30. And finally knocked down around the 20-yard line. That'll be first down yardage for Cam Johnson, the junior out of Brentwood, Tennessee.
We've seen Ken Seals complete passes from the pocket, and now they put him on the move on third down. This is why Derek Mason was so enamored with Ken Seals, the true freshman, stepping in under center.
This is something Todd Fitch brings to the table, the new offensive coordinator. They'll go a lot of up-tempo, no huddle.
And you'll see a lot of different formations, multiple personnel groups, two tight ends and a back, you know, one back and then four wide receivers. They mix it up a lot, keep a defense really, really on its heels.
Todd Fitch doing great work, as you mentioned, Andre, at Louisiana Tech, working under head coach Skip Holtz. Second down and 8 inside the 20 of the Aggies. Seals again hands off. And again, not
what a run.
Wakefield with second effort keeps the legs churning. Nice job by Jamari Wakefield, and finally brought down by Jalen Jones.
And there wasn't any help, like an offensive lineman behind him pushing him. You know, that was all Jamari Wakefield. Carrying guys, that is just determination. Another Mike's third down and medium here for Vanderbilt.
Impressive opening drive, third down and 4 inside the 15-yard line.
Boy, they could run the option right now just to the wide side of the field and give it to the back, and he may be able to outrun the entire defense to the first down marker.
Fandy already 3 for 3 on third down. Not this time. Wakefield brought down from behind by big number 92, Jaden Peavy.
Yeah, it was just a situation where you block the end man on the line of scrimmage. There's nobody for the quarterback, nobody to take the pitch man. And you just flick it out there and let him just run. But when you go between the tackles, now you have to really account for all the bodies inside. Derek Mason going to elect to go ahead and try to put some points on the board.
This might be one of the most athletic kickers in the country, Pearson Cook. He actually runs with the DBs and the wideouts in practice from 33 out. Perfect. And Vanderbilt, what an impressive opening drive, gets on the board first. 3-0 our score here at College Station. Impressive opening drive for the Commodores. 13 plays, 60 yards in over 6 minutes off the clock. A 3-0 lead for the heavy underdog Vanderbilt Commodores, as the Aggies will look to see their first possession of 2020. Kick will bounce in the end zone, and the Aggies will take it out. Ill-advised play there that time, and Vanderbilt stops them inside the 10-yard line. That's the freshman Chase Lane, and that's a freshman mistake, Andre.
Yeah, I guess the adrenaline's pumping a little too much, and saw him. He's kind of feeling things before the game, but you got to be smart. Just kneel that one down and take the field position at the 25-yard line.
So here is our first look at the senior Kellen Mond, the young man out of San Antonio, young overall, but the most savvy veteran in the league, the only 3-year starter. And Andre, I know you believe he's got a chance to have a real breakout season in 2020.
I really do, because of the five guys in front of him, a big tight end who should be an All-American this year, and a young wide receiving core that is just full of talent.
Anias Smith is the lone back on first down. They'll fake it to him, swing it out, and it's bobbled. Dangerous play, bobbled by a tight end. And Jalen Weidermeyer has got a chance to have an All-American season.
Yeah, he is a special player at 6'5", 265 pounds, runs somewhere between 4'6 and 4'7, and just really starting to understand online blocking. Got really, really improved in that area throughout the offseason.
That was Kellen Mond's top target in key situations last year at 6 touchdown receptions.
Yeah, that led the team to 6 TD receptions.
On second down, Mond under hot pursuit, rifles one, and that'll be incomplete. So already behind the eight ball, the Aggies offense, 3rd and 10.
I always say you can throw them, but you can't go catch them. That one's accurate, should have been caught. You see already Kellen Mond's ability to work within the pocket, something we talked about at the top, that he wanted to improve on this offseason and spent a lot of time doing that.
It is a raw wide receiver group, very talented, but extremely young and inexperienced. Commodores send 4 on 3rd and 10. Mond from the pocket completes it. Rifles one complete to Chase Lane, the freshman.
Can we hold on to that? What a catch. I thought maybe at the very end this ball came out. It was certainly should have been caught. Now it's going to rule it incomplete.
Yeah.
But he's thrown two balls that were accurate that should have been caught. And A&M, because of a bad decision by Chase Lane to bring it out, going to punt from their end zone.
Constantino, the freshman punter. And we'll take a friendly Aggies bounce and go out of bounds just inside the 40-yard lines. The Commodores will have their second drive.
You see their offensive turnovers. Third offensive coordinator in 3 years, and now Todd Fitch leading the way. A lot of turnover at Vanderbilt.
They have had 8 different coordinators overall over the last 6 years at Vanderbilt. Pass complete in the flat near side. And that'll be Chris Pierce on the reception. He's a senior, had 14 grabs a year ago, and the coaching staff says he had the best summer camp of any of the wideouts.
Yeah, he had a big catch in that first drive to move the chains, but a big frame, and they love to move him around. A guy that knows the offense inside and out, and when you can do that, especially with his size at 6'4", 231, you make yourself even that much more important to the offense, and then you wind up getting a lot of balls thrown your way.
Vanderbilt was 3 of 4 on third down on the opening drive. A third and 10 here as the Commodores will go with a 4-wide look.
This is when the ball's got to come out quickly.
Pass is deflected, incomplete. Nobody really had a chance at that one. Bresnahan was the closest white jersey to the football, and Vanderbilt will have to punt it away.
You know, I know it's an incompletion, but I like it because of the, you know, the awareness of the situation he's in. He knows his third down. He knows his, you know, third and long, and the ball has got to come out. You know, this is pass rush time, and they're coming after me. Make a quick decision and live with it. And I like how the young player right now, the true freshman, Ken Seals, is playing.
Smith, the punter, and Anias Smith back to return and has to leave his feet and haul it in on the move at the 25-yard line. Aggies will have it when we come back. Vandy leads it 3-0. Mike Morgan back with you alongside Andre Ware, Taylor Davis, 3-0 Vanderbilt leading Texas A&M here in the first quarter. The 2020 has been an unprecedented year in so many ways. Thankfully, we have college football. That was in doubt. It was in doubt in 1919, 101 years ago, when you had the Spanish flu epidemic going on, and that's when Coach Dana X. Bible, a former Aggies legendary coach, wrote to one of his players, Chick Harrison, urging him to play in the 1919 season, saying a rebirth of college spirit has come into the hearts of every A&M man. And they would wind up playing, going undefeated, and later crowned national champions of 1919. So here we are 101 years later, Andre Ware.
Yeah, I mean, you know, this is that an omen that it's getting ready to happen again? Oh, this is a talented bunch. You know,
I don't know if they
can't
match.
Rule it out.
Yeah, I mean, they outscored their opponents 275-0. So that would definitely be a hard act to follow. It's one thing to go undefeated. It's another thing not to give up a point.
I do think it's a talented group that they have everything in front of them. I mean, everything. A talented offensive line, a defensive front. That gives you a chance right there. And then you have a quarterback starting for in this offense for his third year, third consecutive year. Got to like their chances.
Mond 22-12 lifetime as a starter. Hands it off to Smith. Modest gain before brought down by Anthony Orji.
Yeah, Jimbo Fisher, head coach, told us that he's just been a different guy during camp. Just different. Correcting these young receivers that you talk about, really just kind of leading everybody, both, you know, through his play as well as verbally. He's just different in his senior year.
On first down, Mond rifles it complete at the 39, breaking one tackle and racing down the sideline, trucking defenders inside the 40, and finally brought down is Anias Smith. What a catch and run by the sophomore out of Sugar Land, Texas.
Yeah, what you like as a quarterback and as a coach is that he catches the ball, gets right up the field. There's no wasted movement. It's a hit it vertically, and then I'm going to get just physical with everybody. And then you love that at the end. Two hands on the football to make sure that it doesn't come out.
I love their two-headed monster at tailback with Smith and Isaiah Spiller, a pair of talented sophomores. Now in plus territory now, first down and 10. Mond gives to the up back, and that'll be Spiller bulldozing ahead for a couple. Andre Mintz on the stop for the Commodores.
Now we mentioned it for Vanderbilt, one of the keys to this game, limit the run. They can't live in second down and short all game long. It is a recipe for disaster. Got to figure out a way to stop this Texas A&M running game.
Fifth play of the drive for the Aggies.
Well, he's got press coverage, a little hitch down here at the bottom. He backs off.
Mond out of the pocket. Misses one complete, making defenders miss, and finally brought down inside the 25-yard line. That is the freshman Cam Brown, the son of the former Super Bowl MVP Larry Brown.
That's nice, quick out. Ball's on time where he can do something with it after the catch, and then that's just determination in terms of the yards after the catch. Go ahead and give me a few more.
His father was a 12th round draft pick of the Dallas Cowboys, turned into a fine pro, and again, an MVP of the Super Bowl. From the 25, Mond surveys and in and out of the hands of Chapman. So that's what, three drops now, Andre?
I don't know if my count is accurate. I was going to say three or four. I thought it was maybe a fourth drop because he started the drive 0 for 3, and it seemed like everything in that first drive was dropped. This may be nerves from a young group, but hey, it's game day.
Commodores, four-man front on second and 10. Mond, little pitch play to the near side. Past the 20, inside the 10, lunging for the end zone, touchdown! Anais Smith, what a run!
I thought earlier Vanderbilt was going to go to it when they were down in the red zone against Texas A&M on their initial drive. Well, it's A&M that comes back with the option. Nice, quick decision by Kellen Mond. And then the rest, Smith just showing his athletic ability, getting him into the end zone. Boy, what a run after the option pitch.
Gotta love this duo of running backs for Texas A&M, Anais Smith and Isaiah Spiller. Two extremely talented sophomores. A seven play, 75-yard drive. Extra point by Seth Small is knocked through, and the Aggies take the lead. 3:33 to go from College Station. A&M 7, Vanderbilt 3.
Najee Harris runs it in from there, and it is all tied. On a day where being highly ranked can be dangerous, it doesn't.
Dari, thank you so much. Look forward to seeing you guys later tonight. With time, Seals uncorks a deep ball, and it's somehow caught. What a magic reception there by Abdur Rahman. Reels it in front of Fuller.
Excellent throw. Nice job of working and stopping as you're rolling, just stopping to try, you know, find a way. Fit it in the best way you certainly can. And when you have one-on-one coverage, a lot of things happen. And sometimes in a good way for the quarterback.
Grinding out another run is Jamari Wakefield, the most physical of the backs. Transferred in on another tackle for the Aggies.
I've been impressed overall with this Vanderbilt offense. I know they punted the football their last drive, but right now, and that first drive, just solid football.
Again breaking tackles is Jamari Wakefield, finally brought down by the last level of defense, Leon O'Neal.
Boy, he's one of those backs that over time during a game, you're not willing to step in there and go one-on-one with him. You're going to find a shoelace, an ankle. You're not taking him on but above the waist in the fourth quarter.
You mentioned the troubles for Vanderbilt offensively last year. They averaged 16 and a half points a game. That was dead last in the conference. They'll keep it on the ground. This time it's going to be Marlowe, but this time it'll be a loss on the play. O'Neal drops him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, trying to find a 1-2 punch with Wakefield and Marlowe, and I think they've got it. You've got speed and excellent zone runner with Marlowe. You've got the power game coming from Jamari Wakefield. But an excellent play in the backfield there by Leon O'Neal, who they told us, Coach Elko told us, the safety is going to be big in this game, filling the alleys, tackling in space one-on-one.
Again on the ground, modest gain for Marlowe. In on the stop to Marvin Leal, and that is a young man, number 8 for Texas A&M, who's got all kinds of ability.
A 5-star recruit and a broken bone, I think, in his hand last year really slowed him. But he has had an outstanding fall camp, and every coach on this staff just raves about that young man.
Vanderbilt holding strong through a one quarter of play. The Aggies lead it 7-3. Back with you at Kyle Field, College Station. Vanderbilt's been good on third down. They've got a third and 11 here. Seals, the freshman, quick pass inside, and A&M read it all the way.
And the big fella that we just talked about, Leal, agile at 6'4", 290 pounds, and getting out in space making plays. Now, we know he can make plays between the tackles, but when you can do that, that's just raw athletic ability. A force of field goal attempt here for Vanderbilt.
Cook hit one earlier on the first drive. This one will be from 45 yards out. They say he's got a great leg from 50 and in. Snap is good, hold is true, and it will hook left.
Plenty of distance, just started hooking on it. Already, Kellen Mond has found five different receivers, and we're extremely early in this ball game, but continuing to spread it around.
Mond out of the shotgun with time over the middle, complete. That's Chase Lane with his second catch. Young man out of Houston, Texas.
Has really come on from a hamstring injury that he suffered early in camp, but this is the receiver that Kellen Mond said that he had the most chemistry with. Expect him to find Chase Lane in some third down situations because of that chemistry. Guys have worked together throughout the offseason, caught a lot of passes.
And they're roommates.
And they're roommates.
Never hurts from the chemistry standpoint. Seventh play of the drive for the Aggies. Mond lobs one, end zone incomplete. Well covered on the play by that Vanderbilt secondary. Jalen Preston, the intended target.
Interesting play selection. It's been run dominant on first down for the Aggies. Seven passes, only two runs, and that just shows you the confidence that Jimbo Fisher has in his senior quarterback, Kellen Mond, to come out on first down, let him throw it around a little bit.
Mond, quick pass, little inside screen, and now trying to weave his way out of traffic is Chase Lane, going all the way across the field and finally escorted out of bounds by Demetri Moore.
53 and a third yards wide is the field, and he got just about all of it. I mean, stretching it out and not a whole lot on the tail end of it.
It's Alston Orji credited for the tackle.
This is when Vanderbilt has to get off the field, Mike. Got to come up big on third downs. Coach Roof talked to us about that this week. See if they're able to do it here.
Third and 13. Three-man rush by Vandy. Mond has it knocked out of his hand. That might be a free ball. Scooped up by Vanderbilt and brought down at the 46-yard line. We'll see what they call on the play, but it's Mintz scooping up the football.
The ruling on the field was a fumble recovered by the defense.
The pass rush of Andre Mintz to get to the arm of Kellen Mond and deflect the ball out. Not sure if his arm was going forward or not, but what an effort by Andre Mintz, the senior outside linebacker.
Mintz knocked it loose. Jerkins on the recovery for Vanderbilt.
Had an interesting conversation with that young man and just very passionate about his senior year. See if indeed Kellen Mond's arm was coming forward. I don't think so. I think that's a fumble.
Yep. Empty hand.
No doubt about it. Yeah.
So Commodores take over on the turnover. Texas A&M last year was dead last in turnover margin, -6. And a costly turnover there.
And that will cost you a lot of ball games when you're -6 on the season. That's exactly why a talented roster finished 8-5. You turn it over. Even my 12 and under AAU team, I tell them all the time, you turn the ball over, you're going to put yourself in a position to lose games.
On 2nd and 9, and lassoed down. It's like Leal on the tackle of Ken Seals.
Well, you you are talking about something special in Leal. I mean, the ability to change directions. That's the second, essentially, open field tackle. Vanderbilt tried to run a screen. He was out in the open field making a tackle. This is a defensive lineman we're talking about.
Yeah, five-star recruit out of San Antonio. Third down and 8 for the Commodores. Rolling out right, the freshman Seals. Uncorks one into double coverage and incomplete. A tough one. Tried to thread the needle to Cam Johnson, but he was well covered on the play.
Well, you just don't want anything bad to happen if you're Ken Seals. Go ahead, and that's why you punt the football. You want every drive to end on a kick of some sort, whether it's an extra point, a field goal, or a punt. But you don't want to turn the ball over and give the momentum right back to this Aggie defense.
Smith on to punt for the Commodores. And Anaya Smith, fleet of foot, back to receive.
Oof. I mean, every time he touches it, he has you on the edge of his seat because you don't know what move he's going to pull out at that particular time.
He's going to field this one in the end zone. He's thinking about taking it out. Oh, he's going. Forget about a touchback. And not a good decision that he's wrapped up at the 10-yard line.
Yeah, they're going to have a block in the back, so half the distance. Trying to free him up. I'm not sure exactly who it was, but clearly a block in the back. Right there. Maybe Brian George, when a reserve corner. Trying to help his punt returner out a little bit. But Jimbo's giving Anais an earful for bringing that baby out and not letting it bounce to the back. That's two times that both Chase Lane should have downed the ball in the end zone. And,
right.
And there, Anais Smith should have gone ahead and let that one go through
during
and get
the
ball.
Personal foul. Blindside block. Number 16 of the receiving team. The foul occurred in the end zone. By rule, the result of the play is a safety.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, wow.
So 2 points on the board for Vanderbilt. Crucial mistake by the Aggies. Yeah. Commodores, the benefactor of a safety on a punt return. Now 7-5 our score. And Andre, we're going to see two critical mistakes on this play.
Yeah, a lot of coachable points on this one particular play. You're supposed to plant your feet at the 10-yard line and not go backwards. And if it goes over your head, let it go into the end zone. Then the block in the back. It's kind of really adding on to an already bad situation that's taken place.
You and I were talking over the break. I don't think I've ever seen a safety on a punt return because normally you don't return a punt from the end zone.
Pretty confident in his abilities, maybe a little bit too confident for Coach Fisher, who caught him right as he was coming off the field. And so did Brian George. He got a pretty good talking to as well.
Not only is it 2 points, it's possession and a severe momentum change for Vanderbilt. Returning it from the 10 and rocked at about the 27, 28 yard line. So the Commodores will get it back with 7:15 to go first half.
And
big hole left side.
Sorry about that, Mike.
No problem. Marlowe out to the 40 yard line.
A nice block here. It's kind of just a front side trap. And Marlowe, who's more of the zone runner, does an excellent job in terms of some positive yards on first down.
How about that catch? Beautiful
Mike
pass
Leach.
And a great job of holding on. That's
making
Bresnahan,
grand,
the tight end.
Yeah, but Mike Leach making a grand entrance into the SEC down in Baton Rouge. But how about the timing? Ken Seals to his big tight end Ben Bresnahan, and I mean that's got to be timed perfectly between three Aggie defenders.
From the 40, draw play, and not much there. Stacked up after a gain of about a couple miles. Jones stopping Javion Marlowe.
Impressive footwork by Marlowe because he had to make his first move right after the handoff. He was still in the backfield, and whatever he got, the 2 yards he picked up, that's bonus. That's a heck of a job of making guys miss between the tackles.
Vanderbilt on first down tonight. 11 runs and just one pass. Playing fairly conservative for the freshman who's looked good so far. This time, though, a screen pass set up, and A&M was all over it. Pass caught by Justin Ball, the tight end, but he was surrounded.
And an excellent play from the safety, Damani Richardson. Kind of sniffed out the screen, knew it was there, and was right in the hip pocket of Bresnahan when he made the catch.
Third down at 11. Seals. Cox a deep ball. And nowhere near any intended target there. Might not have been on the same page intended perhaps for Abdur Rahman.
Abdur Rahman kind of hooked up the route. Seals thinking that he's going to go ahead and run the fade to the end zone. And the two are kind of not on the same page there. You hate it because it just burns an opportunity to put together some type of scoring drop. And it's a respectable first half for Kellen Mond. 9 of 16 for 99 yards, but with a bunch of drops mixed in there.
Fair catch in traffic, hauled in by Anaya Smith. From the 16, Mond looking to run. Mond nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. Sacked. Odengbo brings him down.
Talked about the creases that this defensive line, and they're not blitzing. It's just the front four taking care of business, keeping Kellen Mond, and that might have been a designed quarterback draw. But by the way that by Kellen Mond's body language, but they didn't allow him to get outside the box. And then when you have that happen, you got a chance.
Now do they take a chance here? Or do they play a conservative with the clock ticking down under 45 seconds to go first half?
Now my foot would still be on the gas.
They will put it on the ground, and that will likely be the final play of the first half, a half that Vanderbilt will gladly take. Vanderbilt has taken a little bit of the life out of Kyle Field in the first half, just a 2-point lead for the Aggies. Texas A&M, an early touchdown, Vanderbilt an early field goal, and a safety on a punt return by Texas A&M. Taylor, take it away.
Coach, you told us week one would be a lot about not causing self-inflicted wounds. We saw a couple of those in the first half. How would you assess that effort?
Very, very poorly. I mean, we had two major screw-ups on special teams. I mean, that's ridiculous what happened there. We have a big penalty. We're down to the two-yard line. We had the three and out. Then we scored a touchdown, and we got another driver to the two. Then we have a play on third down. Got a guy wide open. We're going to throw the touchdown, get it knocked out of our hand. And then we have the bad drive down here on that. We only had it four times. So, I mean, we need to clean it up. We're giving up too many third down conversions on defense, too many run yards in there. Play a little soft inside. We got to get more physical on both sides of the ball and control the line of scrimmage. I'm not happy with the line of scrimmage at all, and we got to make it smarter with the football.
This Vanderbilt defense has held your team to just one score. How do you increase offensive production?
Well, go out and execute. Execute and get the ball back. We'd only had it three times until the last time. We were about to score two times, two out of three. So we got to get it back from defense. We got to maximize on offense.
Thank you, Coach.
That is one fired up Jimbo Fisher. He said a mouthful right there.
Yeah.
Texas A&M leading it 7-5 as we go to the studio with Dari, Chris, and Gene Chizik. Bit of a slugfest in the first half at Kyle Field in College Station, Texas. The Aggies up by just 2, 7-5. As we get ready for the start of the third quarter, Mike Morgan, Andre Ware, Taylor Davis.
And that might help improve their first half stats, which are brought to you by Zaxby's. Who would have thought Vanderbilt dead last in the SEC in offense a year ago, outgaining the Aggies in that first half. Again, crucial mistakes by the Aggies keeping this game close. And we'll now see if Vanderbilt's defense can remain salty in the second half. But I want to know, Andre Ware, what are we looking for out of Kellen Mond in this explosive A&M offense in the second half?
I find the playmakers, the running game with Spiller, Anaya Smith, get him the ball in space to let him operate. And Jalen Wattemeyer, he needs to touch the football a lot more than he did in the first half.
Wattemeyer had just two catches for 19 yards in the first half. Mond out of the shotgun. Feeds the tailback, cutting back. This is Spiller. Spiller weaving his way through traffic in the open field. Spiller with one man to beat. Down the 40, past the 30, and inside the 20-yard line. Finally knocked out of bounds by Maxwell Worship.
Well, you go to guys that have made plays for you. A fantastic job by the offensive line. A little zone blocking, and it allows Spiller the cutback lanes. And then it's just all Isaiah Spiller in the open field, power, speed. Excellent job down the field by this receiving core of Texas A&M.
It was Kaufman pushing him out of bounds after a 58-yard run.
That's
ball
exactly
spotted
what
at
you,
the 18.
Exactly what you wanted if you're Texas A&M and Vanderbilt, the worst thing that could happen to you.
Spiller. Burrow is his way for a yard. Orgy on the stop for the Commodores.
I say that, Mike, because now you're backed up. It's a shot in the arm for the Aggie offense that's been kind of sputtering a little bit, or sputtered in the first half. And now you get them rolling a little bit with that run with some confidence.
A 58-yard run, the longest play for the Aggies in this game. Now second down and 9. Mond gets out of traffic. Tosses underneath at the 10. 5. Touchdown. Caleb Chapman.
Well, you go all the way back to the open, and we talked about Kellen Mond being able to make plays off schedule. He gets flushed from the pocket. Nice job by Chapman of just finding an area of the field and showing his numbers to the quarterback. And right on the money was Kellen Mond.
That is the response every Texas A&M fan wanted to see.
You think that little paint peeled off the locker room walls at halftime, Coach Fisher?
Coach Fisher was fired up with our own Taylor Davis. I can only imagine what he told his team in the locker room. Three-play, 75-yard drive. The Aggies, Kellen Mond tosses a touchdown pass. 14-5 our score. Aggies on top, 14-5. There is no normal in 2020. We've certainly learned that. Well, at the half, the Fighting Texas Aggie band, that's not them performing live. In fact, this is the first time. You got to go back 1894 when we started football at A&M that they did not perform live at the half, so they pre-recorded. And here they are watching on the Jumbotron, kind of evaluating their performance. I'm no band expert, Andre, but I'm going to give them two thumbs up.
I'll give them two thumbs up. I was captivated with them in last year's bowl game against Oklahoma State in the Texas Bowl.
That says something.
Yeah, it was a pretty special performance, and enjoyed it thoroughly. Usually I'm somewhere trying to find some food in the press box at the half, but I stayed through that entire performance.
Let's see the performance of this Vanderbilt offense here to start their first drive of the second half as we say hello to Taylor Davis.
I spoke with Derek Mason about this offense. He said he's been super pleased with their productivity in the first half, other than some key mistakes. He said the offensive line is doing a great job, wants to continue to see them create those gaps for the hard-pounding running game they're showing and keep the pocket clean. He wants to see the pass game start to come together this half.
Taylor, good stuff, and certainly got to be happy with that offensive line and the job that they did, and we talked about this at the top. They're a bit of a revamped line. You've got a starting guard in Drew Birchmeyer, number 57, who actually was a defensive lineman last year. But they felt like they needed some girth up in the middle. You see him playing right guard there. Sometimes you got to do whatever you can to make it right. So far, so good with this line tonight. They've played well. Seals. Rifles one complete. Beautiful throw and a beautiful catch by the tight end, Bresnahan.
Well, they've had some pretty good tight ends come through this program. Pinckney being the legend, Jared Pinckney of last year, but Bresnahan with an outstanding grab there and an accurate throw from the true freshman quarterback, Ken Seals.
And they go to the ground instead with Wakefield.
It's just so tough to go about your business when you don't push the ball down the field and threaten the defense. And I know he tosses the interception, but that's a mix-up with a wide receiver. You know, you talk those things through and you come back. But you can't just eliminate that from your offensive playbook. Got to be willing to take some shots.
That's a good point. I mean, even the interception, it wasn't a bad throw. It's clearly two guys not on the same page. He hasn't missed many throws tonight. Seals again going to hand it off to Wakefield. And again, no daylight. And third down and 11. Another tackle for Leon O'Neal.
Yeah, because what happens is you see a bunch of bodies, guys creeping into the box late. You got seven there already, and you're bringing an eighth guy up to defend the run because you know Vanderbilt's not going to push it down the field. So maybe the recipe for running the football is to spread them out and at least give the vision that you're going to throw it and then hand it off underneath.
Commodores 4-10 on third down. It's third down and 11. Four wide formation. The freshman Seals goes underneath, complete, and that'll be good for a first down. Abdur Rahman with his third grab of the night.
Here, Abdur Rahman on a crossing route and a nice job of improvising. Boy, so close for Buddy Johnson, but just can't get a hand on the football and have a fresh set of downs.
16 yards on the hookup. No gain on the carry.
Good to see that big guy back in action.
Dari, good stuff. Of course, Mike Bobo, the new offensive coordinator for the Gamecocks, former Georgia OC. Reuniting with Bill Muschamp, the head coach. As Vanderbilt goes back to the ground game. And Javion Marlowe brought down by Buddy Johnson.
It's just been a nice... Vanderbilt's done a nice job of hanging around in this game. Now you want to see some explosive plays. Get Marlowe out in space, maybe.
We got a third down at 8 here. Kind of spread it around. Really not a true go-to guy.
You just got to have somebody win a man-to-man, which is all this is. Cover one.
Pressure for the backside. Pass is complete.
Boy,
nice throw. Good grab.
Boy, back shoulder. We call it a fade stop when I was at Houston. But it's an intentional underthrow. Throwing to the back shoulder of the receiver to stop him in his tracks. And the cornerback's up the field.
14 yards on the hookup to Rahman, who's become the favorite target tonight of Ken Seals. That's his fourth grab.
You see that tempo change. They go right to the line of scrimmage. A little bit too fast for me.
Well, that's something Todd Fitch did a lot of at Louisiana Tech. With Skip Holtz, a lot of up-tempo, a lot of no huddle. Try to keep the defense off guard. See another Aggie defender limping off the field. That's Jaden Peavy.
We talked about it earlier. I think Derek Mason just absolutely hit a home run with his hires for these two coordinators, Fitch and Coach Roof.
Now Fitch is a great story. You know, he was a player at Ohio Wesleyan back in 1982. He was new to the program. The guy that helped him really acclimate was the football manager. That was Tim Corbin, one of the premier baseball coaches who's won two national championships at Vanderbilt. They've been reunited at Nashville. Second down and 6. Feed to the near side.
Wow,
not much
shot
there. A whole lot of pad popping going on as Marlowe goes down and Buddy Johnson continues to rack up hard hits.
Yeah, the quarterback of this defense and one of their leaders comes up big time in space. Well, you can hear the pads popping and just stops Marlowe right in his tracks. Think he spends a little time in the weight room?
Yeah, just a little bit. That's a chiseled 240. Not a whole lot of body fat on that frame. Another third down of the drive. Third and five. Seals on a rollout. Looking deep. End zone. Caught it. Touchdown. What a throw. And another grab by Abdur Rahman.
How about the throw from the true freshman quarterback, Ken Seals? And this is on the move, and he puts it about the only place that he could put it for it to be a completion. Running out of room, over the outstretched hands of the defender, and what a job by Rahman getting his feet down in bounds.
I know I've been impressed by the freshman Ken Seals, but when a Heisman Trophy quarterback Andre Wertz is impressed,
it's
that's
just
another
way,
story.
Yeah, it's the way he's carried himself through this game. No highs, no lows. And just kind of going about his business and doing his job. And no moment's been too big. You're talking about making your first start at Kyle Field here in College Station.
Love his composure. Absolutely. Does not look like a freshman tonight. Nine-play drive, 43 yards. The touchdown after the A&M fumble. To the ground game on first down and nothing doing. Spiller in the big paws of Rashawn Wilkins.
Yeah, the junior college transfer. They said he's just mean. Just a mean player, just angry all the time when he puts the helmet and shoulder pads on. And he's just gotten better since his time, since he's been on campus. He's really earned the respect of his teammates.
Commodore showing blitz on second down. They dial it up. Mond, quick throw, and completes it. Diving grab at the 30. That's Chapman again. That's his third reception.
He's mostly a special teams player, Chapman, in 2019. And with all this youth, he's kind of climbed the depth chart and made his way on the field. Caught a touchdown pass earlier. And he can really, he's got great speed. He can really take the top off of defense.
Of course, the game going on simultaneous to ours. South Carolina, Tennessee. Mond over the middle, completes. One of his best passes of the night as he missiles that one to Cam Brown.
What a big catch earlier in the first half, but this is just a slant, and he allows it to get into the second window. Can hit a receiver right out of his break in the first one or a line to pass a defender into that second window. And Kellen Mond does actually an excellent job of taking Cam Brown into the second window.
16 yards on that hookup. Mond and company from the 46. Four-man rush by Vandy. Pass
nice.
Complete. And Kellen Mond starting to heat up a little bit. That's Chapman again.
This is a nice job right here. Quick out where you just put it outside away from the defender who's inside. And you still have a little bit of room with Chapman for him to do something after. But the play I'm impressed about was the slant. The first window's before the DB. He throws him into the second window knowing that the defensive back is trying to undercut it. I'm going to win with the football with my eyes. Take the defender out wide. Throw you inside, and all Cam Brown has to do is run through it for the catch. That's playing on another level right there.
10 more yards, another first down for the Aggies on the move late third quarter. 2-point game. Spiller takes it left side, breaks a tackle at the 40, inside the 30, and tripped up at the 15-yard line. Finally brought down by Randall Haney.
Boy, second and one, it's Spiller time. Nice job up front by the Aggie offensive line, and hey, he's shaking tacklers. and a nice job in terms of his speed and getting vertical up the field. No wasted movement. Now they're clicking on offense.
Good way to end the third quarter if you're Texas A&M. The final 15 from College Station coming your way. It's a two-point game. Mike Morgan with Andre Ware and Taylor Davis at Kyle Field, College Station, Texas. The Aggies on the move, sixth play of the drive. Up by two, 14 to 12. Mond starting to catch fire on this drive. Looking to throw here, all kinds of time, end zone, and overshoots his intended target. Intended for the back, Anias Smith.
That's one he'll beat himself up in terms of film study tomorrow. And he had him. Receivers open, just been a little high at times, but love the way he's sitting in the pocket. Love the body language. It's relaxed. He's just gotta put it on the receiver.
Chapman has been his favorite target tonight. He's at the top of your screen. Four grabs for the sophomore. Now in motion. Mond in the pocket. Looking, end zone again, and in and out of the hands of Smith.
Yeah, pretty good play by Alan George in coverage from that cornerback spot. Just kind of waiting on Smith on an out and up. There's a nice job of just kind of getting the football out of there.
Good coverage by Orji, the sophomore.
Thought it was George, 28-26. Starting to look the same to me.
They really like Anthony Orji. They believe he's going to be a dude. He's a converted safety. Mond fleshed out, looking to run. And inside the 10, some tough hits all the way to the 7-yard line, brought down by Orji.
Well, when you have a quarterback that can give you that every once in a while, you're not asking Kellen Mond to do that, you know, over and over again. But when he can do it and it's third down and long, now you get to fourth and two.
What do
you
do here,
Andre? Puts it on
the
coach's mind whether you go for it or not. I think he's going to take the points, no doubt.
Yeah.
Go ahead and put the points on the board.
Yeah, we're talking about a kicker that last year from 40 and under was 16 out of 17. Seth Small, the junior. He is true on this one. Now the Aggies settle for three and lead it by five.
Still right where they want to be are the Commodores.
Let's check in with Taylor Davis.
Well, guys, I asked Derek Mason his thoughts on his true freshman quarterback's first half, and he said what stood out to him was his maturity. He said having Ken Seals is like having a 26-year-old quarterback. He said this guy has nothing but composure. It's exactly what I expected. And keep in mind, guys, he's just the third true freshman quarterback in the SEC to start a season opener. And look, even though this place is at 25% capacity, it is still loud, and the Aggie band is directly behind the Vanderbilt side. But he has remained composed. He's constantly communicating with his offensive coordinator as well as his receivers. Really seems like a veteran for a true freshman.
Dancing around on the sideline to some music that's kind of gotten in his blood a little bit. And he's, you know, you'd never know that he was down by five playing the fourth quarter of his first start.
He's been unfazed, and he's doing it against a pretty stout Texas A&M defense. Another return man taking it 7 yards deep out of the end zone, and another poor decision. So now Ken Seals, the freshman, goes to work under heavy pursuit and wisely just throws it away.
And that's why you like Seals, because even with things flying around all around him, he's still composed. Nice job of stepping up in the pocket. He sees a defender coming right at him. Holds the ball, trying to still find a receiver downfield. Okay, it's not there. Let's just throw it away and play on second down.
It's heavy pressure by Andre White, sophomore by way of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
You get the sense he's just having fun. He's just having fun back there.
I mean, if he is nervous, he's certainly not showing it. Misfires on that throw. Great coverage. Cam Johnson really could not separate that time.
They're going to have to find someone that can beat man-to-man coverage.
You know, last year, had,
go ahead, Mike.
Yeah, I was going to say, last year, you had Lipscomb, you had Pinckney. Yeah. I mean, these were pro-type weapons, not to mention Keyshawn Vaughn, who's in the NFL. They're still trying to figure out who their best weapons are right now.
You got to find Pierce, Abdur-Rahman. Someone got to come up with a big play right now.
Quick drop, heavy pressure, going to get out of the pocket and going to tuck it and run. Gets rocked at midfield, but good yardage. Hansford on the stop for the Aggies.
It's decision time for Derek Mason. A lot of time on the clock, but you don't know what's going to happen going forward. You have the football now. It's fourth down and about one to pick up the first down here. And he just put his body on the line to pick up that first down and show some confidence in this offensive line right here.
I love this call if they do wind up snapping it.
I don't think they're going to snap it, not with him being under center.
Wakefield behind him. They do snap it, and it's play action to Wakefield. First down, beautiful call by Todd Finch, the OC, and beautiful execution by the freshman.
Todd Finch, you sneaky devil, you. I mean, he goes under. I'm thinking he's just going to bark out signals, try to get the Aggies to jump off sides. They do snap the football, and he's able to get Wakefield leveraged outside of the defense. What a call by Todd Finch and Derek Mason.
And the Commodores are in plus territory, under 9 minutes to play, a one possession game. Seals hands off Wakefield, gets to the edge, shoved out of bounds. Another tackle for Buddy Johnson, but a good pickup on the play.
I mean, there was no way, because you can go back and count on maybe about three fingers when Ken Seals has gone under center. Everything's been basically from the gun. And then he's got you fooled thinking, oh, they're just going to not snap it and bark signals.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness.
Oh, boy.
Defense number 5. 15-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
That's on Bobby Brown, and that is a crucial mistake.
Just a couple of instances where this Aggie football team is self-destructed, and find Bobby Brown. He's not, you can't miss him. There he is, the bottom of the screen, right in the back of Drew Birchmeyer.
Completely
way
unnecessary. Big mistake. Now first down. And lowering the shoulder and plowing ahead is Wakefield.
You know that comment I made earlier in the game about you get to the fourth quarter, you stop taking him on about his shoulder pads?
Yep.
It has happened. He is delivering the blow now coming downhill.
6'1", 225, fifth year senior out of Jacksonville, Florida. We'll get a breather here. Commodores in the red zone. With time, Seals now no time, brought down.
That's when you got to be coached up to the point of, hey, get rid of it. You get to the top of your drop, the ball's got to come out, because you can't pump any momentum into this A&M defense. More than enough time to sail the football, and you should be stepping up to escape, because the pressure, you feel it coming from the outside. It's a step up. You got Leal coming full speed from the blind side. You're not going to outrun him. So step up into the pocket or just throw the football away and come back on third down.
First A&M sack of the night. Third and 17 over the middle. Tipped up and intercepted. Picked off by Leon O'Neill. O'Neal knocked out of bounds near the 40, 15. And that might be a late flag. It is indeed a frustration penalty on Vanderbilt, and now tempers flaring on the sideline. Chris Pierce took an extra shot, and that'll help the Aggies get some more yardage.
Just lost his composure totally. You got to know where you are on the field. And Pierce, after this is tipped up into the air, this young man's played one heck of a game, O'Neal, from his safety spot, but Pierce just loses his composure. You can't elevate and slam someone like that
after the play
on the field, let alone on the sideline.
Against Vanderbilt.
And you know, you go back to that throw. This is one of the few poor decisions by Ken Seals tonight. They're right into double coverage. There's no way he's getting that ball to Cam Johnson.
Yeah, I think it all started with the pressure on the sack the previous play, and then you're trying to get it all back at one time, throwing into coverage, as you mentioned, and O'Neal is the benefactor of that.
Well, now the Commodores defense in need of a stop here.
Well, this is when you want your 4-minute offense to just bleed this clock, but you get points on the back end of it.
Mond over the middle. Almost intercepted, in and out of the hands of Jalen Weidermeyer. And I got to say, it's not been a great game for Weidermeyer tonight, but in fairness, his grandmother passed away recently, probably playing with a heavy heart tonight.
Yeah, and a lot of people from my hometown in Dickinson mourning the loss of Miss Melvina Weidermeyer. I've known her since I was all my life, pretty much. And so, yeah, every time I saw her, she had a smile on her face, followed by a big hug. And see, the one thing I know is she loved watching her boys play sports, and now her grandson, certainly. And my condolences to the Weidermeyer family.
Absolutely.
May she rest in peace, no doubt.
On second down, Mond flares it out far side. Nice run after catch by Chase Lane. And two roommates connecting on that throw, Mond to the young man out of Houston, Texas, Chase Lane. One of the burners on this great receiving core.
How about the confidence that Jimbo Fisher, you're up by 5 points, turnover, and you come out slinging it. That's confidence in your senior quarterback right there, that he's going to take care of the football. We're going to go ahead and play out this fourth quarter, trying to get points on this drive, rather than move the football on the ground with Spiller and Smith to really burn some of this clock.
Under 6 minutes to go on third down and one. To the ground game.
Wow.
I don't think so. Spiller brought backwards. Great pursuit by Rashawn Wilkins and cleaned up by Deshaun Jerkins.
You've called Jerkins his name a couple of times. And I mean, he met Spiller in the hole. Both of them did. Oh, what a heck of a job there. And if you're Jimbo Fisher, do you roll the dice and go for it here on fourth and one? I think so. I think you give the ball right back to Spiller again and let this offensive line prove its worth.
The Aggies leading Vanderbilt 17-12. Aggies going for it on fourth and one. Mond hands it to Spiller. Fumbled football. I believe Vandy's got it.
Got to unpeel a couple of jerseys and bodies. And I mean, every time they have an opportunity to put the game away, the Commodores force a turnover. And they don't just force them, they recover it.
Fourth fumble of the night for the Aggies.
The fumble was recovered by Texas A&M, but the ball was short of the line of game. We turn over on downs. First down, Vanderbilt.
So it's not a fumble.
Right.
But it's still short of the line to gain, which is the first down marker.
Yeah.
And I just can't believe what I'm witnessing here with this A&M group.
Unofficially now, that's actually the fifth fumble, third. Only three recoveries for Vanderbilt, I say only. But the Aggies have put it on the ground 5 times tonight. They've lost it 3 times. And it cost them there on fourth down and one. Home run ball on first down. And good coverage on the play.
That
time by Miles Jones, their best cover man.
Well, that was one of the things that Todd Fitch talked to us about, is they wanted to make hit some shot plays down the field. One-on-one matchups, you're going to have some of these big-bodied receivers like Pierce make some plays for you, and they need it desperately here with about 4 minutes, 50 seconds left. They are still within striking range with some great field position to start this drive.
Second down and 10, under 5 minutes to go in this game. Little dump off pass underneath. Aggies read it. Aggies stuff it. Not much doing that time for Marlowe. Another stop for Buddy Johnson, who's been everywhere.
Heck of a job as well, Mike, by Leon O'Neill. He really got him to turn back inside, and then every name that you call thereafter was around the football. But that young man filling the alleys from the safety spot. See him out there in space, turn Marlowe back inside, and a bunch of maroon jerseys show up in a bad way.
And a lot of people tuning in right now that never would have thought this would be a one possession game in the fourth quarter. Third and 11, and the Aggies get a sack. No answer for Michael Clemens, the junior college transfer.
They have raved about the fall camp that Michael Clemens has had. Considered one of the best junior college pass rushers coming out a couple of years ago, and it is starting to pay off. All 6'5", 270 pounds of him getting to the quarterback, Ken Seals.
Third sack of the night for that Aggies defense. And boy, do they need it to come up in a big way on that drive, and they got him. Fair catch hauled in by Smith. 3:24 to play. Still plenty of time. The Aggies clinging to a 5-point lead. Kellen Mond looking for his 23rd victory as a starter in his career at Texas A&M. Rather pedestrian numbers for him. Give the Vanderbilt defense credit. They have been stingy and salty tonight to keep this a one possession game in the fourth quarter.
And taking away opportunities and winning in terms of time of possession. But, you know, now if you're Kellen Mond, it's ball security. Those are the two words that are first and foremost in his mind.
Vanderbilt does have two timeouts remaining. Nice stick in the hole that time by number 24 for the Commodores. That's Alston Orgy.
And that's what you're talking about on the sideline. You get to the huddle, you tell your team again before you break the huddle and get to the line of scrimmage, hey fellas, let's hold on to the football.
And if you're Vandy, I mean, you've got plenty of time here. You force a punt.
Two timeouts. Mm-hmm. Yeah, plenty of time.
On second down and 9, Mond from the gun, rolling out left. He's going to keep it himself. Is drilled at the 40-yard line. That's the other Orgy, Anthony Orgy. The two brothers have had a big game, both from Rockwall, Texas. Mond on 3rd and 5, and wide open in the flat is Preston, and he'll lunge forward for some extra yardage, but move the chains for the Aggies.
That clock will stop briefly as they move the chains. Once they're set, it starts to go again, but what timing. Confidence in your quarterback. Nice out route, and Kellen Mond puts it right on. Jalen Preston stays inbounds, the smart thing to do. And they continue on with a fresh set of downs.
Now, if you're Vanderbilt, your margin of error is dwindling to 0. You've got to get a stop here. Only one timeout left, clock ticking away. Under 2 minutes remaining. Smith stuck near the line of scrimmage, jammed up by a number of Commodore defenders.
How much of a luxury is it, though, when you have a senior quarterback that you can put the ball in the air with that amount of time on it with the pass to Jalen Preston? That shows a tremendous amount of confidence in that young man, Kellen Mond, that he's going to make the right decision. And it's happened. It had to happen over an entire fall camp that he's made the right decisions, puts the ball in the best place and gives A&M a chance to win. And that's been proven out. And that's why Jimbo Fisher has elected to do that. Otherwise, he would just run this clock with Isaiah Miller and Anaya Smith and try to get out of here. But he's, you get in a situation in a third down and long, hey, flip it out there and show some, he's shown the confidence in Kellen Mond.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct against the Vanderbilt head coach. 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Well, you know, you have that rule where he can't come on the field, and probably giving someone, yep, on the field, and that's what that call is all about right there.
Game clock operator.
Trying to get a timeout.
Well, you go from second and eight to first down and 10. Little eye formation look for the Aggies. Smith dots the eye, gets the carry, and goes down at the line.
A lot of bodies around the football, and they're going to maybe spend their last time out. And see that mask, the RTI for on Derek Mason. It stands for relentless, tough, and intelligent. And that's what this entire football team, this entire program, is being built on this season. Andre Mintz, he mentioned it as we were in a conversation with him. Derek Mason dropped it a couple of times, but that's what he wants to be known for: relentless, tough, and intelligent.
Well, I think it's safe to say that his team has been all of that tonight. I don't think many people thought this would be a 5-point game. Aggies are going to win it, but they are going to escape in a lot of ways. Derek Mason still fired up. The Commodores, a valiant effort on the road against a top 10 team, but Texas A&M really picked it up offensively, Andre, in the second half.
Yeah, they did. I mean, you got Spiller going, Anaya Smith made some plays, Kellen Mond through the air, he made, you know, some plays with Jalen Preston. Caleb Chapman may be the go-to receiver at 6'5", 195, certainly down in the red zone. And then you had Cam Brown step up. So some young players starting to surround their veteran quarterback in Kellen Mond.
Not flashy numbers for Mond tonight, but a dub is a dub. And Texas A&M now 12-3 under third-year coach Jimbo Fisher after a 9-year stint in Tallahassee with the Seminoles, trying to get to that next level this year in College Station. We'll have some things to build on. We've got a tough couple of games coming up with Alabama and Florida. Taylor Davis has been able to get a hold of one elusive Jimbo Fisher. Taylor, take it away.
Thanks, Mike. Coach, a hard-fought battle down to the wire. Now that your team has a game under their belt, what are your thoughts on this group?
Well, I mean, we got a lot of work to do. I mean, critical turnovers on offense. We got a pull right there. We're going to pull that ball and score on the fourth and one. Turned it over in their territory three or four times. Had a chance to put the game away. Our defense, I thought the second half did a heck of a job. Made big stands. Got two critical big turnovers. Set us up offensively besides the first drive down. And we only punted twice in the game. That's the bad part. We either turned it over, scored, or, I mean, just so much inconsistent. But that's my fault. That's my fault as a coach, and I take responsibility for that.
Coach, you mentioned your defense. Vanderbilt gained momentum multiple times.
Yes, they did.
Your defense prevented them from capitalizing on it. What did you like on that side?
They played great red zone defense. We bent, give up too many third downs on some things, some big ones. But then at the end, we did a really good job of getting two big turnovers.
Well, Coach, you anticipated you would learn a lot here in week one. We all are, right? As you head into an SEC-only schedule the rest of the season, what will you take away from tonight?
Yeah, we need a lot of work to do, but listen, our kids fought. They played hard. They did do that. But we got a lot of work to do if we're going to play this schedule and do what we need to do.
Thank you so much, Coach.
Thank you.
Taylor, good stuff. And it's not just the schedule. It's the next two games specifically on the schedule. How about at Alabama and at home against Florida, who looked terrific tonight in a win against Ole Miss. Once again, the final score of the Aggies defeat Vanderbilt 17-12. For Andre Ware, Taylor Davis, and our entire SEC Network crew, Mike Morgan saying so long for now.